It is a stat card.
URL dropped the Till Death Do Us Part card, and it is crazy. I mean, every battle on this card should be one of them ones. Starting from the bottom, Pat Stay versus Real Sick. Pat had a last time we seen Pat was pretty questionable outing versus K-Shine. I don't know what really happened there. It seemed like he didn't come prepared. Looked like he showed up to the card late. Pat Stay is known for his tough exterior and being a bully. And then to the next round, he could say like the funniest jokes that have you laughing out of your seats. Go in so many different pockets. You have no idea how to prepare for him. He's a very tough opponent to prepare for. So it would be pretty interesting. Real Sick had one of the best battles of the year versus Av. But even though he had a good showing, a lot of people felt like he lost that battle. So even though how structured Real Sick is with his material, where he just tries to beat you with good angles, punchlines, getting different flows, it just was not enough against Av. And that was a really good Sick. I think Real Sick will probably have to rap a little longer than he's used to and be one of the best Real Sicks we ever seen, or he will have two L's under his belt back to back. Jazz Rapper versus Gaddis. I went over this over my last video. I got Gaddis taking this. She's like a chameleon. She's very similar to Hollow, where she can just go into different, she could get into different flows, she can freestyle, she could be aggressive, she's funny, so you have no idea which way she's coming.
Pause.
Yeah, and I think a lot of people just sleeping on her.
Pause.
I know the polls probably have Jazz winning, but I think that if it's no crowd room, which I'm hearing that it's supposed to be a no crowd, I think it's going to be advantage Gaddis. Next on the card, Rex versus Rum Nitty. This is a rematch. They battled a few years back on the Snoop Dogg card, I believe, and Rum Nitty got smoked, but that was a different Rum Nitty. It isn't the Rum Nitty that we know of today. I'm confident that Rum Nitty will come back and beat Rex convincingly, or or not convincingly, maybe edge him 2-1 on that. Surf vs. Calico. This is another rematch. Calico was good the last two battles. Surf has been good only one of his last battle. And this is a shorter time frame, so I'm not sure how well Surf can craft his material to be able to be flawless like the way he was versus John John. And with it being in a small room, disadvantage Surf. I don't see him winning this. I give it to Calico in an upset because, you know, everyone is on the Surf bandwagon, and I think that he's going to lose that. Mook versus Easy to Block Captain. This is a tough one. When you think about a closed room, and the last time we've seen Mook in that bag was versus Rock, and that was a really good showing from Mook. And with all the bad reviews with people not liking Mook's performance and versus Reed, I think he's going to get in a completely different bag, especially he's going against someone in the new era. So Easy to Block Captain has a lot to prove. He has a lot on the line for his class going against Murder Mook, the icon, the Jordan of battle rap. So you already know Easy isn't going to take this easy, no pun. Easy's going to go in there and talk to him. Talk to a soul. I think he's going to talk to Mook the way most of us at home hopes he would. Because you know Mook, everyone wants to see Mook. He's the icon. And he's a big trash talker. People want to shut him up. People want to put him in his place. People want to tell him that he's not fit for this era. He can't battle in this era. He's not as good. He's not number one. So no matter what he says. So people will just want to shut him up, and Easy to Block Captain is the number one person from his class that can do it. Tayrock versus Twerk. I think this battle should be a little bit lower on the card. I'm not really excited on this battle because you don't know what Twerk you're going to get. Rock is still trying to reclaim his spot of still having it. So I'm not really excited. It's probably the least excited. This is by far the worst matchup on this card. I'm not interested in this. Many people aren't interested in this. I got Twerk 2-1. Now the battle of the card, Lux versus Geechee Gotti. Geechee is going to leave Earth on Lux. He is not going to mess up. No choking. I believe he's going to talk to Lux the way nobody has talked to him before. Geechee just has so much class, and Geechee doesn't really lose. I mean, when was the last time he lost? I mean, Geechee don't really lose. He's the front runner for champion of the year, and he got Lux headlining the Drake card. But Lux is no slouch. Just like some of the other battlers on this card, we don't know what type of Lux is going to show up. Lux hasn't really battled a Miracle Spiritual battler yet. You wouldn't consider Geechee like a top five pen in a game, so we probably won't get a Lux that's super lyrical. So with that being said, I got Geechee edging this one. He just has a lot to talk about. He has a lot to prove. He has a lot to say to some of these old era cats. He has a lot to say to the Smack DVD class. And what better person to do it? I mean, I have all the confidence in the world Geechee is gonna bring it home. But this card is amazing. Amazing. I can't wait for it. So this is Battle Rap Critic. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. Peace out.